The spirit of Sidney Lumet hangs over my BFI player choice this week, the third feature from writer-director J.C. Chander, building on the promise of the edgy financial thriller Margin Call and the Robert Redford shipwrecker All Is Lost, with a crime thriller set in 1981, a most violent year.
Catherine! Katie! Where did you get this? Catherine? Tell me where you found this.
Here in the yard.
Show me! Where?
It was just sitting right here behind
the Did you see this?
Well, yeah, she went under there to get that ball and came out with it.
Maria!
Is it real?
We in trouble.
Maria!
Oscar Isaac and Jessica Chastain are the American dream couple, struggling to expand their domestic heating fuel business. But with his fuel trucks being hijacked on a daily basis and the DA's office on his back, Isaac's Colombian-born Abel Morales is struggling to stay on the right side of the law. Meanwhile, Chastain's doughty mob daughter Anna urges her husband to sort things out before she does it for him, observing ominously, "You're not going to like what will happen if I get involved." With the exception of a sharp three-way shootout in a strangely somber chase sequence, this keeps its action tinder largely dry, the fireworks generated instead by tense conversations between husbands and wives, lawyers and district attorneys, police and thieves. Chastain is terrific as the Lady Macbeth power behind the throne, chiding the authorities for being very disrespectful while cooking the company books with fingernail-saving disdain. Meanwhile, Isaac is a portrait of manicured, camel-coated anxiety, a man struggling to maintain his moral code cool amid overstretched mortgages and 30-day payment deadlines. Top marks, too, to David Oyelowo as the DA whose crime-busting clampdown masks naked political ambition, and Albert Brooks as the world-weary, dyspeptic lawyer walking the thin blue line between his client and the authorities. Cinematographer Bradford Young, who performed nostalgic wonders with 35mm stock on David Lowery's Ain't Them Bodies Saints, here opts for yellow-tinged Scope Digital to capture the chilly vistas of New York's underworld with added Detroit grime, the brisk exteriors arrestingly counterposed against brooding interiors. Completing the picture is an angsty, synth-inflected score from Alex Ebert, who cites synth-punk band Suicide as a tonal touchstone, evoking the period milieu without recourse to plastic pastiche.